Welcome to Subramani. Thank you for subscribing. Many people come and ask me, what are the advantages of holding shares or equity mutual funds? And for me, because I've been in here for about 40 years, I keep wondering, is there something to even ask? Isn't it very obvious? But I guess it's not very obvious. So let me just enumerate. First, growth in value. Definitely a good share bought and held over a long period of time grows in value. So therefore, there is an advantage. It can generate income. So yes, you don't immediately see the income because the dividend yields in India are very poor. But having said that, over a period of time, you will start getting 100%, 150%, 200% or 300% of your cost, right? So you'll start getting that kind of a return. So like other assets, it also generates income. Third, you just don't have to pay tax till you do not sell it. That's a huge advantage. If you were to keep money in a bank deposit, on the interest you'll have to pay tax. Now, in a equity share, you're compensated in two ways. One is you get a dividend, and second, you get growth. The growth is not taxed till you sell, which means after 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, whatever, till 20 years you get tax-free growth. Fourth, more importantly, whenever you pay tax, you pay capital gains tax. Capital gains tax has always traditionally been lesser than your regular tax. Now, suppose you are a very high-paid executive, you are on a 2 crore plus salary, and you have got bank fixed deposits, even on that you will end up paying 43% tax. Now that is a ridiculously high rate to pay on an asset where the yield is less than the market rates, right? If inflation in India is 8% and you get 7% in the bank deposit, then you're paying 40% tax on that, which means another 3 rupees is gone. So you're getting about 4% return. That's completely unfair. Whereas in an equity fund or in a direct equity, you do not pay tax till you do not sell it, right? And always, like, you can always postpone your tax. You can decide to pay tax after the age of 65 when maybe you're paying lesser tax, right? Another very good reason to hold equity is it's an amazing hedge against inflation. We saw that it creates value. Why does it have to create value? What happens if it doesn't create value? Well, in a place where inflation is low, it may not matter. If inflation is 1% and the bank interest is that you're getting or fixed interest that you're getting is 2%, then it may not matter. But in a country which is like India, where interest rates fluctuate, in fact, I think maybe we are at the nadir of our interest rate cycle. And we will watch it going up. I do not know how much up, but yes, definitely interest rates will go up after some time. So you need protection against that. So you need protection against inflation. Your growing economy will inflate. Suppose inflation is 6-7%, then you need an asset which will grow at a rate greater than that, right? So all these are then you don't, as of now at least, you do not have estate duty. So when you give it to your children, you give it clean. And very importantly, if children are not interested, they can sell it off without creating a murmur. Imagine selling a house in the village worth a couple of crores and everybody talking about, oh, this is the price, that is the price. Whereas you sell 2 crores or even sell 200 crores worth of too few shares in the stock exchanges, nobody needs to know, right? So those are the advantages. Thank you.